What's the gnarliest place you ever skated?
Gotta be Burnside.
They were calling it a skate park when it was a parking lot with two little ramps against the wall. And they were, Burnside Park. It's a fucking parking lot.
It never really occurred to us that this was gonna be our thing. It just was something that we did to have a place to skate.
Basically, we're just poor, more. The more we built, the more rad it was, and like the more people came, it was magic.
These two dudes came together as a concrete power duo.
Oh, Redneck, you gotta meet this guy. You'll be like looking in the mirror.
Red called me and he's like, yeah, come on down. Lincoln City wants a park on the coast. And I was like, really?
You know, Red, he's actually getting hired to build one of these parks. This is insane.
Lincoln City, power spot on the planet.
Red and Hubbard, they built this. This was their first paid job. And now, 20 years later, everyone's coming back for a big skate jam weekend.
So what's next after Lincoln City?
Today, Lincoln City, tomorrow, the world.
The needle was in the red at all times with these guys.
Oh my. I don't know where I'd be without her. I'd probably be 6 feet under.
Whether it was shit burning down or shit building up,
we kind of figured it out. We're like, you know, I think this is gonna blow up.
These were gnarly guys slinging concrete under the bridge. And then the next thing you know, they have these thriving businesses, and then they start to have families. This is a radical transformation.
We went from one company to two companies.
You got Grindland, you got Dreamland. These guys are building parks all over the world.
Everyone dreams of doing what Hubbard and Red did. It's taking something that you love to do with your friends and building a life out of it.
It is, it's emotional, for sure. There's punkers with tears out there. Good fucking therapy.
They changed skateboarding forever. They showed that you don't have to wait. You really can do it yourself.
What are you doing? Working hard?